Hi there, Taurus, and welcome back to Star-Lord's Tarot. This is your tarot forecast for the week of April the 8th through to the 14th. I went ahead, shuffled the cards, laid them all out. Let's see what's going on for Taurus. First up, we have the Ace of Wands in the upright, followed then by the King of Swords upright. Next, we have the Five of Wands upright, followed then by the Temperance in the upright, and lastly we have the Nine of Swords reversed. So your overall energy is the Ace of Wands in the upright position. Not too bad. I do love aces because they do usher in some kind of new beginning. And this looks like it's going to be an exciting one for you, Taurus, because the Ace of Wands ushers in that sort of, you know, brand new perspective. Sometimes it can be the return of passion, something that's lost its passion. Sometimes we, you know, in our careers, our jobs, our daily lives, relationships, a lot of things can sometimes lose their luster after a while. The passion just sort of fades away. This can indicate a return of passion for some of you. For others of you, this could indicate something new is coming in. And it could be the beginning of a project. It could be the beginning of a prospect to perhaps do some traveling, because it does govern travel. It could be perhaps a new startup for a new business or something like that. Even a new hobby, a new relationship for sure that starts off on such a quite grand, passionate, beginning. So beautiful energy. Right at the beginning of the week, we have the King of Swords here. This is air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, or Rising. Some of you could be dealing with an air sign, but you could also be dealing with a legal matter or a surgical matter. Sometimes the sword people can represent surgery. This is important information coming towards you about these serious subjects. You could be consulting a lawyer. Sometimes the King of Swords can represent, you know, police officers, lawyers, judges, arbitrators, that kind of thing. Can be somebody in the military. There could be important news about them or coming from them. So there could be something going on in the court system. A lot of people have, you know, legal matters going on. There could be some news in that respect. Next card up is the Five of Wands in the upright position. Everybody knows that's not my favorite energy. This is a lot of he said, she said nonsense that just sort of, wastes our energy and wastes our time debating it. And I call it the full moon madness energy. It's like that week before the full moon when everybody gets all up in arms, and then once the full moon comes and goes, nobody really cares about the subject matter anymore. So we've just wasted all this time and energy and maybe made a few enemies along the way by buying into it. So bypass that. If that is going on, a Taurus, for you, just try and step away from the drama. Always suggest that. For others of you, it could make sense. Maybe you have entered into a realm of competition. See, this could be the new passion here. Maybe you're going into a competitive field, or perhaps there's a lot of competition in the field you're going after, a job that you're going after, or even in a career. You could be having, you know, a lot of scrimmages in that respect. Others of you, maybe it makes sense because you're part of a team. There could be something going on. Maybe, you know, you play competitive sports or something like that, and this could be a competition that is ensuing at that time. Moving on towards the weekend, we see the Temperance here. It's Sagittarius energy. Temperance is all about cooperation, balance, patience, that kind of thing. It's also very healing energy. So for some of you, you could be looking at mixing and blending and having things turn out great. I call this my baker's card. So if any of you are baking towards the end of the week, it looks like it will come out beautifully. Also too, if you are put in charge of an event, it could be at home or it could be at work, where you're the one who has to sort of put everything together, you know, order the food, get all the people together. Could be that this event turns out beautifully. Great news for those of you who just started working with a new team or something like that. This is cooperation. And you have found your tribe. You're working in accordance with others you know, who are on the same page. Last card you have here is the Four of Swords in the reverse position. This is all about letting go of anxiety. Now, Four of Swords in the upright position can point to multiple anxiety, to having so many things on our mind that, and we keep ruminating over and over and over again, and we can't seem to get any peaceful rest. This can be for some of you where you are trying to solve 9 different problems. You were trying to solve 9 different problems, and you know, in the middle of the night, we think it's a great idea for some reason to keep ourselves awake trying to resolve issues and problems. Could have been one main problem, you were trying to find 9 different solutions for it. But whatever it was that was causing the upset and the anxiety, it looks like it's coming to an end because the 9 of Swords here is now in the reverse position. So this indicates that you will be getting some kind of relief from that anxiety of those sleepless nights. It's weekend energy, maybe. This is a good thing. Some of you can relax over the weekend and catch up on some sleep. There is something new, fun, exciting going on here. Perhaps this is what, you know, changes you from this anxiety into this. Maybe this could indicate for some of you a new job, right? And maybe there's a lot of competition, you know, into getting that job. But now you're in it and you realize that this is your tribe. These are the right kind of people for you to be working alongside of or working with. So it is really good energy, really good, helpful energy. And that's why your anxiety has dissipated, it looks like. So it looks like a pretty good week for you. Love the Ace of Wands here for you. And the King of Swords could be clearing up a matter, and it could be, maybe that's what was keeping you in that Nine of Swords energy. It could have been you were worried about an arbitration or a legal matter or something. And now it looks like, you know, everything has been put to rest. So all's well that ends well, I like to say, in situations like this. The beginning of the week, we do see a little bit of a scrimmage here. Hopefully it's not about the eclipse, because that's when that big eclipse is happening on the 8th of April. And speaking of the eclipse, make sure to join us on Sunday evening on the channel here. We will be live with Marie Moore, astrologer, and we're going to be talking a lot about the eclipse and, you know, all the stuff that's going on out there, all the hype, all the different theories. We're going to be getting in depth about all of that. So make sure to join us. You can join us in the live chat. If you don't get to come live, it's Sunday at 6 p.m. Just come to the channel, wait for the live stream to start. And if you happen to miss it, you can't make it or what have you, you can always watch it on the replay. Just come to the channel. At the top of the channel, there is the, you know, videos, shorts, it says, and live. Just click on the live. You'll see all of the podcasts are there. So hope to see you there, and take care of yourself. I want to thank you very much for joining me, and I really, really hope you have a great week, and I hope the reading helped you. If it did, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. Much love. Namaste. Bye-bye for now.